So in my previous video, I answered the 5 top questions that I keep getting over and over in relation to email marketing for ebook authors who want to sell their ebooks. So if you've missed that video, then I'll put a link in the description box below so you can go back and check that out. Now in this video, I want to finish up this series by answering 5 more questions that I see to help you understand how to use email to sell your ebooks and other info products. And real quick, before we dive into this video, I've got something really special that's going to make your journey of selling your own ebooks much easier, and that is my 10-day action plan to launching and selling your own digital product that gives you a focused plan for how to get everything set up and start selling, which is free to access, and you can check the description box below for the link to join. All right, so let's start with the 6th question that I get asked, and that is, what are some common mistakes to avoid when using email to sell your ebooks? Now, when it comes to email marketing, there are several pitfalls that many ebook authors, they unknowingly fall into. These are some things that I would suggest that you avoid. And that is 1, inconsistency. That is the number one reason why people will unsubscribe from your email list. Your subscribers need to hear from you regularly. So don't vanish for months and then suddenly show up with something that you have to sell. I see this all the time in my inbox. I would subscribe to an email list and then months later, they email me and I'm not quite sure who this is. So naturally, I'm going to unsubscribe from them. So don't make this a mistake that you do as well. How you can overcome this is create a consistent schedule to send emails to your list. So that might be sending once a week or bi-weekly, and make sure that you're sticking to it, right? The next mistake that I see is that you're focused too much on selling, right? So I get it, you're trying to sell your ebook, but your emails shouldn't be all about hard selling. Instead, you want to provide value, you want to provide education, you want to inspire your readers, you want to create inspirational content. And the thing is, what this does is when you offer helpful content and you occasionally, sometimes pitch your product in between, subscribers are going to be more receptive to your offers. One of the mistakes that people make is not segmenting their email list. So for example, somebody might have just joined your email list. You don't really want to send them your broadcast emails, especially when they might have a series of emails to go through as you welcome them for the first time. So for example, in my own email list, when people join, I allow them to go through a series, which I refer to as my welcome series. And then at the end of that welcome series, I'm then adding them into my regular email list where I would send my regular newsletters. So you want to make sure that you're segmenting them, as well as I also look at people who might click on my emails, who might open a specific email, because then I can segment those groups of people and send them a specific offer because I know that they are the most engaged in my email list. So these are some of the things that you can do as well. Tailoring your emails to different segments can significantly boost your open and sales rates. So keep that in mind. And sometimes people tell me that they don't really know what to say to their subscribers. And if you're one of those who are not quite sure what to say, then don't worry. I have prepared for you some free email templates that you can get started in setting up emails to launch your ebook. And I've made sure to put a link in the description box below. Okay, so let's go on to the next question. And that question is a very popular question. And that is, how do you actually deal with unsubscribes? Now, I want to tell you something. When I got started with email marketing, I used to always look at my subscribers and see who was actually unsubscribing, and I would have gotten so disheartened and disappointed. But there is one thing that I learned, and that is unsubscribes is just really part of email marketing. In fact, today I don't usually study it anymore. What I focus on are people getting onto my email list, and if they leave, then that's okay. That just means that they're not for me. They probably would not have bought my products anyway. So what was the point in having them on your email list? Unsubscribes in some ways helps you to maintain an engaged and high quality list, and people might unsubscribe many different reasons, and unfortunately not all of them are in your control. But if you find that you're getting a lot of unsubscribes, like over 1% of your email list are unsubscribing every day, then here are some things that you can pay attention to. Provide consistent value so people have a reason to stay. You also want to set expectations to your email subscribers from the very start, from the moment that they subscribe to your email list. Like, for example, what type of content you're going to send, or also how often you are going to email them, so they just have an idea of what to expect as they stay on your email list. Okay, another question that I have seen is, what exactly should I be tracking to determine whether or not my emails are performing? Now, I like tracking my open rates. These rates tell you how many people are actually opening your emails. And if you recognize that your open rates are low, then take a look at your subject lines and see whether or not they are interesting enough, because that's what actually encourages people to open your emails. An open rate, for example, could be, or good open rate rather, could be about the, let's say, 25 to 30% mark. I also like looking at my click-through rate, and that is how many people actually clicked on a link in an email. So for example, if you're selling your ebook and you have included a link to your ebook sales page, then are people actually clicking on that link? And if not, then you have a low click-through rate, and that could mean that maybe the email content isn't inspiring them or motivating your subscribers enough to want to check out your ebook. Also, I like to look at my unsubscribe rate. So if you have a high unsubscribe rate that's over 1%, that could mean that your content is probably not meeting your subscribers' expectations. So think about, again, are you attracting the right types of people? Maybe change up your content. You can even also do a survey of those subscribers to see exactly what type of content they are looking forward to. Okay, let's go on to the next question, and that is it a good idea to cross promote or promote other digital products or ebooks to your email subscribers? And I give a resounding yes. I mean, I sell multiple different digital products and ebooks to my subscribers all the time, because I don't really know which product is going to resonate well with them. But by doing this, this is what has actually helped me get more sales. And here's a few ways that you can do it. If you have people who have bought your ebook, you could then follow up and promote something like a workbook or a course that complements the actual ebook. So let's say your ebook is on writing, then you may have a course or a workbook on self-publishing, for example. So you make sure that it's closely related to the product that they initially bought. You could also create a special offer where subscribers can buy two or more of the products that you sell at a discount. So this is something that you could do perhaps during a special sales event like Black Friday. And then the final question that I'm covering as part of this series is, what's the best way to follow up with potential buyers who didn't purchase from you the very first time? Not everyone on your email list is going to buy your ebook if they see it the first time, right? So here's what I like to do. I like tracking people who have opened my emails or clicked on my links, but they didn't go on to buy something from me. Then I'm going to follow up specifically with those people by sending them emails about the benefits of the product. I want to address common objections, maybe also answer popular FAQs that they have, and I'll even send them some testimonials as well. And also, sometimes a sense of urgency can encourage people to take action. So to those people who have already opened my emails and or checked out my product, I'm going to send them like a limited time discount or bonus to purchase within a specific period of time. You could also share a story about how your ebook has helped someone else, or how it has even transformed your own life. I've mentioned before that stories resonate, and if someone is on the fence, it can easily persuade them to buy. And then also, you want to make sure that you are restating the problem that your ebook solves and the transformation that it offers, right? You want to reinforce why your product is worth buying. So I hope that if you had any questions about email marketing, that this video series really helped you to answer them, so that in some way you can level up your email marketing and sell more ebooks. I want to thank you so much for watching my video. If you haven't caught part one of the series, then make sure to go back and have a look at it. There's a link in the description box below. Thank you so much for watching my video, and I'll see you in the next one.